My name is Joan Holbert Hubert, and we are here in Galveston, Texas, at the beautiful Middle Passage marker that was put here by the Galveston Historical Foundation African American Heritage Committee. I went to Ghana, West Africa, some years ago, and before then, I had never heard of the Middle Passage. So if you look at this and think of one, two, three, this is the Middle Passage. Now, according to the historians, there were millions who had been taken from the West African coast, especially. There are ships that came from Madagascar, which is where my ancestors came from, so I'm really interested in that. But they came all the way through to the Americas, not just to North America, but to South America, to Central America, and to North America especially, because they needed the trade, they needed the people, they needed the free labor. So it's not that this just started 100 years ago or 200 years ago. You can trace it back to 1450, even to 1300, even to 1200. I'm a member of the Galveston Historical Foundation African American Heritage Committee. I went by one of their meetings and brought a proposal that we have a marker to commemorate the Middle Passage in Galveston. And of course, being a historical foundation and a heritage committee, they wanted proof. Here's what I found. There were estimated, as I said, about 10 to 15 million who came. And in this area, there were millions who were lost. Those souls were lost because if there was a disease on board the ship, people were thrown overboard. If someone decided that they could not go to a foreign land that they did not know about, they committed suicide by jumping overboard. So there were millions. Galveston was the biggest slave port west of New Orleans, and they traded quite regularly with New Orleans and Mississippi. And it's not hard to come around the Gulf of Mexico to Galveston. And if you look at what happened back in 1513, the very first record of a slave was Estevanico. He was a Moroccan slave, a Moor, and he jumped ship in Galveston and came into the interior of Texas. Around, they think it was like Clear Lake, coming into Houston. So Galveston was an important place. I have ties here in Galveston with family who worked on the docks, who worked in the cotton mill over there. And so there are so many people here in Galveston who were born according to the Middle Passage. Now you look at it and you think it only came to this part of America. It was a very lucrative trade, and especially when they were dealing with human cargo. There were people who have still making money because of their ancestors who had human cargo working for them for free. There are ties with banks and oil companies and all of that who are a part of this illicit and illegal trade. I do want to say that one of the most famous people that people will remember or recognize is Jean Lafitte. He was a pirate, and of course everybody knows about Jean Lafitte and his actions and the things that he did. Well, he was one of the biggest slave traders, but he was a hoodlum and had to be run out of town. So that's when he stopped his and went to somewhere else. But all along the Gulf Coast, you'll find Jean Lafitte. I trace my lineage back to Madagascar and to Senegal, Mali, Ghana, and to Benin. And I wondered how we got here. Once I started my research, now I know. And according to my research, there was one pirate whose name was Hugh Frater. And my family name is Frater. And Hugh Frater went to Barbados, and he went to Antigua, and Jamaica. And if you go to those places, you will find hundreds of freighters. And if you come to Texas and North Carolina, you'll find hundreds of freighters. So the Middle Passage is real. It is something that is quite interesting if you look into it. It's something that happened, and now we need to go forward from it and learn from what happened with the middle passage. I thank you so very much for letting me tell you my story about why I'm interested in the middle passage. So it's not so far away in 2021 that you could go back to, say, 1450 and follow the middle passage. These routes are still being used today by ships. So it's my hope that one day we can commemorate the middle passage with a ship from Galveston. I thank you for allowing me to speak today, but I do want to let you know that Galveston is a very rich city full of history. There are things in Galveston, homes in Galveston, that go back to 200, 300 years ago. It is rich with European history and also rich with African history, African-American history. Emancipation Proclamation happened right here in Galveston, 1865, where the enslaved people heard that they were free. Of course, according to the northern part of America, they already knew that in 1863. But 1865, we got the message in Galveston that we were free. So go and visit all of the places of history here in Galveston, Texas.